Bow. What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and we got to talk about Cash Doll, why she hasn't blown up, and maybe some of the things that could help her blow up at this point. Now, for starters, some people might kind of consider her as blown up. In a sense, she does have quite a bit of views on quite a bit of songs, and she has over a million followers on Instagram. But let's go back to the fact that since 2015, she had been listed as an up-and-coming rapper in Detroit. People really thought that she had some momentum. But one of the major reasons she hadn't really blown up like she probably could have since that point is the fact that she had record label troubles. It's something that a lot of fans don't understand when they're like, yo, this artist fell off, or they not doing what they should be doing or could be doing. Record label troubles are a real thing. I believe I heard her mention somewhere that she might not even have been able to release an album within a certain period of time. But still, she had a real fan base, a unique fan base. We'll talk about that a little bit later. But she had a real fan base, and when she was dropping music, she was at least getting 100,000 plus views on quite a few songs over the years. And then in 2017, she dropped that heat with For Everybody. Now, if you haven't heard For Everybody, man, that song was so dope. It's probably her biggest performance song to this date, to my knowledge. And what's so great about it is it's a song that speaks to itself. As a marketer, I don't love anything any more than a song, a product that speaks for itself. The whole premise was this side chick basically calling the wife, and the side chick is just talking that mess the whole song, the whole way through. She's like, yo, we don't really husband these dudes no more. But then at the end of the song, the wife comes back from her perspective and talks about how this chick ain't nobody, dude don't care, this is her dude, she got ownership. Yada, yada, yada. If you listen to the song, it's dope. Just the whole premise. And when I talk about the song speaking from itself, of course, you got some side chick type girls who agree with that perspective. Of course, you have some wife type girls that agree from that perspective. And you see all throughout the comments, side chick won, main chick won. And then you have those third parties that say, yo, both of these chicks took an L from being in this situation in the first place. If you haven't heard For Everybody or seen the video, definitely go check that out. I'll put that in the link description below. I don't care if you're male or female, you gotta see it. Conceptually, I put that on par with Jordan or Lucas's I'm Not Racist. Of course, the issue wasn't as serious, but the way they painted a picture, brought a story together, two perspectives that spark conversation, are right on the money. So I mentioned that song because not only is it dope, but it gave her a huge boost in her fan base, and a lot more people knew her since that time. But on top of that, she has this really unique fan base, and they hold her to this standard. Because if you don't know Cash Doll, well, all you have to do is listen to her quite a bit, and you'll realize that she's a little bit more of a lyrical type artist. And that's what her fans love about her. They love the fact that she's bringing some form of substance, and the fact that her flow is kind of unique. And that's important to understand, because when she dropped a song called Ice Me Out, a lot of her fans were not effing with that song. They said, yo, you usually more lyrical this, where's the substance? Usually you'll kill something like this, but this is kind of just boring. I'm not effing with the song. And in my mind, whoever's on her team or her might have been trying to say, hey, we got this point. We have this great rabid fan base. All we gotta do is drop a nice single that can push past our fan base. It's catchy. Let's get it going. That song was not it, obviously, even though they're still doing challenges to the video up to the date of this. And that is probably what she needs at this point. Some song that will push her to that next level. It's catchy, so people catch on to her and then they say, oh, who's this Cash Doll chick? And then they start to fall through the funnel of all the other dope stuff she's done. But until that happens, she at least has a strong fan base. Now, last note I want to make in terms of Cash Doll is you can be lyrical and make a hit, obviously. The chorus just has to be hard. So her best is probably going to have to be a really dope chorus, but still do her thing in the verses, because her fan base seems to be really critical of her being lyrical or not, or at least coming with that same energy that she usually does or not. You need that initial fan base to push your stuff past where you are right now. So if that regular fan base don't rock with it, it's going to be hard for her to get a song that keeps moving and keeps that same energy past the level that she's in right now and into new areas. So I want to know what you think about Cash Doll. If you follow her already, if you haven't seen For Everybody, check that video out. Let me know what you think about that. And as always, I'm going to be answering questions on Sundays, at least for the rest of this year. So hit me up at BrandmanSean. And if you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. If you like it, you might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.